Another example of things we can do with variable is actually incrementing and decrementing. And this is actually a very, very common pattern. So imagine, you know, you have a Facebook page where you posted a post and you're trying to say, hey, every time somebody's like it, increase it by one. And every time somebody take the like off, we're going to decrease it by one, right? So the way to do that, if I, you know, let's actually do it together. So since I'm counting the number, it's a good candidate for integer, right? So I'm going to say integer likes, okay? So I'm going to define that. At the beginning, my likes are zero, right? I have nobody yet liked that post. So if I want to say, hey, every time somebody like it, so I'm going to add a comment, when someone like post, I'm going to add one. So how do I do that? I can simply say like equal to the existing like and plus one. Why did I have to say the like equal to the like again? Because I want to use the existing value, right? I don't want to start from the beginning every time. If I just said like equal to one, then that's going to change whatever the value and keep it to one. It's not going to increase it by one. It's going to make it equal to one. Okay. Again, the equal sign here is assignment operator, right? It assigned whatever on the right side to the left side. Okay. So we're going to do that. So after I execute this line, what do I expect? Let's check it out. So I'm going to print this out. I'm going to take this in so it doesn't get in our way. And we'll run that. So the value is, as expected, got increased by one. So let's do that again. So let's imagine another one also liked our video or our post. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to say, update the likes. How do you update them? We're going to take the existing likes, add one to them. So after this point, how much I expect the like to be? Two. And that's what I got. Okay. If I did this and ran this quickly, it's going to override my existing value and it's going to give me one again. So you can see this pattern, what we call it, is very, very common, especially if you're working with things that updates frequently. And for that purposes, Java or most of the languages out there actually provide another way of writing this exact thing, which is get the existing value and increase it by one. So the pattern is as follows: A plus plus, A minus minus. So that basically, if we take an example here of X and started with five, and we said plus plus, plus plus, plus plus, plus plus, every time we say that, it's literally the equivalent of X equal to X plus one. And you can do it the other way too. So if you wanted to do a decrement process, you would do A minus minus. So I started with X as a five and I decremented it all the way to minus one here. Okay, so this is, again, trying to get you more comfortable with variables. This is really just a way for you to kind of, you know, a shortcut in a way to work with variables and update them on the fly, right? So if I come back to the code here, and then, you know, if I wanted to do it to the likes, all I need to do is like a plus plus. Okay, you can see my code is happy, no errors or anything. If I did a one plus, it's just gonna throw an error here saying like, hey, I'm missing something, right? And you know, if you hover over it, it says expression expected, like I'm expecting something else, okay? So that's the way you're doing. Again, this is very common and you probably see it around. So we thought it's a good idea to start kind of get familiar with that.